Hello friends, myself Tejas Varke and welcome you in my channel Science and All, where you will get everything very first. In today's video, we are going to discuss about disel cycle. So what is cycle? A cycle is formed by number of processes on which an engine works. Rudolf Disel is a scientist which proposed a cycle called as disel cycle. A disel cycle works on the basic principle of a constant pressure heat addition and a constant volume heat rejection. So this is the basic working principle of disel cycle. Now I have plotted a graph between volume and pressure, and the second graph is between spontaneity and temperature. From the first graph you can see that to complete a cycle the four processes are must required. From 1 to 2 the air which is comes inside the cylinder get compressed, so the pressure get increased. So process 1 to 2 is the isentropic compression process. From 2 to 3 you can see that the pressure is kept constant and volume get increased. So process 2 to 3 is the constant pressure heat addition process. From 3 to 4 you can see that pressure is also decreased and volume is also increased. So process 3 to 4 is the isentropic expansion process, and 4 to 1 you can see that pressure get decreased by keeping the volume constant. So 4 to 1 is the constant volume heat rejection process. So this is all about the processes on which the diesel engine or the diesel cycle works. Now let's derive an expression for the efficiency of diesel cycle. The basic efficiency formula is efficiency equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected upon heat supplied. Now from the graph and from the processes you can see that heat is supplied from 2 to 3, which is constant pressure heat addition process. So heat supplied is given by mcp T3 minus T2, and heat rejected is taken place at process 4 to 1, which is called as constant volume heat rejection process. So heat rejection is given by the formula mcv T4 minus T1. Now let's put this value in the efficiency formula. We get an expression like efficiency equal to mcp T3 minus T2 minus mcv T4 minus T1 upon mcp T3 minus T2, where Cp is specific heat at a constant pressure, Cv is specific heat at a constant volume, and m is the mass. Now let's cancel out the mass on numerator and denominator. We get an expression like Cp T3 minus T2 minus Cv T4 minus T1 upon Cp T3 minus T2. Now let's divide the numerator by Cp T3 minus T2, we get 1 minus Cv T4 minus T1 upon Cp T3 minus T2. Now there is one term which is called as ratio of specific heat, which is given by Cp upon Cv. Now let's put this term which is called as gamma in the above expression. We get 1 minus 1 upon gamma T4 minus T1 upon T3 minus T2. Now let's divide the numerator T4 minus T1 by T1 and the denominator T3 minus T2 by T2. We get an expression like 1 minus 1 upon gamma T1 T4 by T1 minus 1 upon T2 T3 by T2 minus 1. Now we know a relation between temperature and volume in the form of gamma, which is given by T2 by T1 equal to in bracket V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1 equal to V4 by V3 to the power gamma minus 1 equal to T3 by T4. So this is the relation between temperature volume in the form of gamma, and also the one term which is called as compression ratio, which is given by V1 by V2, and the another term is RC, which is cutoff ratio, which is given by V3 by V2. Now putting the relation between temperature volume in the form of gamma, compression ratio and the cutoff ratio, we get an expression like 1 minus RC to the power gamma minus 1 upon compression ratio to the power gamma minus 1 into gamma in bracket RC minus 1. So this is how we get the final expression for efficiency of the diesel cycle. The internal combustion engine which use diesel as a fuel works on the diesel cycle, and we know that the efficiency of diesel cycle and auto cycle is different. The normal compression ratio for the diesel cycle is 16:20, which is so much higher than the auto cycle. So this is all about the diesel cycle. In this video we have discussed about the processes and the efficiency of diesel cycle. So thank you for watching the video. Please like and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe the channel to watch such knowledgeful videos, and please hit the bell icon to get the notification of next uploading video as soon as I upload it. So thank you. Hello.